In today's session, what we are going to do, I'm jumping into the flexible Fiori workflows. Within the simplifications, now we'll be discussing the flexible Fiori workflow. So in our basic sessions, we have already gone through the workflows. We have already gone through classic release strategies. We have already gone through. We already know that what is the classic release strategy and how it would be happening. That part we already know. We would be having a strategy based on the release codes. Then we will be having a characteristics. We will be having a class. We have a with classification release strategy. We have a without classification release strategy that we have gone into the very depth. We have also seen the examples, and we have also seen the challenges. That what are the challenges are there doing it with the classic release strategy? The challenges with the classes, challenges with the characteristics. All of these kind of challenges would be there. So just to again give you a quick preview that what we have discussed and what we are going to discuss today, so that the people who has directly jumped into this course, they would be able to align. So what we have discussed in our last session in the release, basically when we said that flexible Fiori workflow, it is nothing but it's a technique to release your purchase order, release your purchase requisition. Initially, these flexible Fiori workflow started from 1610, and then SAP has went ahead and improved it further. 1709, 1809, 1909. A lot of improvement has happened. Still, there is a huge chance of improvement in the flexible Fiori workflows, but a lot of improvements have happened. Improvements in sense of within the objects with the functionalities, and they have also increased the number of objects through the flexible Fiori workflow. It's starting initially with the procurement, where purchase order and purchase requisition are the first objects which was included for the approval process, and then later on multiple different processes has been included here. Within the procurement also, now we are having your invoices is there, then your everything that they have included, whatever you can think about quotation, they have included the apart from the quotations, apart from the invoices for the services side, the service entry sheets also has been included. So we'll go through the list that what are the different approvals or different documents which can go through the flexible Fiori workflow approval. But just to give you a highlight again, that what we are talking about anyone who wants to buy anything, it need to go through the vendor. So vendor will supply the material, and with this supply of the materials, when the material is supplied, you need to pay back to vendor. Okay, you need to do the payment to the vendor. Now, this process is a very risky process in any organization. Why it is risky? Because you are getting some supplies, services, materials, you are getting it, and you are paying to the vendor. So the money is going out from your organization. So there is a huge and heavy chance of doing a frauds here. Okay, so that's why the full, there's a lot of focus on the procurement release processes. Whatever the documents have been created, it need to pass through the multiple level of approvals so that it goes through the release, and then only the document is given to vendor, and then only we are getting the materials to vendor. It should not happen that somebody has created a service PO for a vendor, and then he has also punched the service entry sheet and the payment has been released. So there would be multiple firewalls would be there. So these approval process, whether it is a flexible Fiori approval or it is your classic release strategy. Classic release strategy, which we do it with the with classification, we do it. I will not jump into the detail because we have covered in the basic part. Or without classification, we can do it with the help of release codes. So this is the existing process. So this process is the existing process. Now SAP came up with the new process, which is a flexible Fiori workflow. Now, why the flexible Fiori workflow has been come? to understand that, you need to little bit understand about the challenges which is there in the release strategy. The first challenge which is there, now I'm talking about challenges which we have in the release strategy. First challenge is there, it's very complex to maintain.